Go ahead.
Okay, we are recording now, so you can go ahead.
Okay, so I want to thank everyone for being here today. I'm going to talk about fact-backed, rules-based trading, which is what I do. Many of you may be familiar with my presentation or my methods, but I'm going to do it anyway. Sometimes a little repetition is good. A little bit early here in California, but this is my usual starting time, so if I'm a little bit hoarse, please forgive me. So I've been all over the world, lectured all over the world, taught traders in every part of the world how to trade, and I always hear the same thing. They're not making enough money. They're losing money. They've been trying hard for a long time and still can't make any money, can't figure the game out. The reason is really simple. They're using things that are subject to interpretation. Anytime you interpret anything in the market or in life, you're subject to make bad mistakes, errors of judgment, thinking that Iran has weapons of mass destruction when they don't, and so forth. So it took me 15 years to realize this. So from when I started trading in 1967, for about 15 years, one moment, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, but it's a very important call. I have to take it. I'll be really quick. Need to call you back. I'm doing a webinar, okay? So, apologies. I did the same thing everyone else was doing. Looking at charts, trend lines, reversals, chart formations, flags, pennants, and so forth, believing everything I read in books. The fact of the matter is that all of those things were subjective. I would look at a chart and come to a different conclusion than somebody else. That does not work. So what I want to do today is talk to you about, sorry about that, I want to talk to you about what I do, how I came to do it, and why. So first the usual disclaimer, and then let's talk about it. So you've probably all seen the commercial. There's a guy sitting at a computer or a girl sitting at a computer, and they're trading, and there's somebody knocking at the door trying to interrupt them. But the person at the computer screen is focused, they're trading, and the commercial says, "Don't get mad, get E-Trade." As if to say, all you need to do is get a computer, get E-Trade, put some money in the account, and you're going to make money. That does not work. So I earn my money the hard way by doing the numbers. I'm a numbers guy. Excuse me. Everything that I do has to have numbers. I'm going to explain to you what I mean. So the bottom line is this. Because I'm a numbers guy, you will see that my ideas, better than anything else, will help you change your life and change your future. But you have to be a numbers person. I'm going to say it very simply. I can't speak for anybody else or anybody else's methodology. But anytime I run into something that doesn't give me all the numbers that I need, I can't do it. I worked very hard for my money. I started with less than nothing. And the only way I've been able to make money is by being a numbers guy. So look at this chart. You will probably recognize this from your studies at school. It is a Rorschach chart. It's an ink blot used by psychologists. When I first started trading, I worked at a mental institution with a clinical psychology background, using tests and measurements to determine if a person needed to be hospitalized for psychiatric illness or not. And one of the tests we would give them is this ink blot test and ask them, what do you see? The answers are all over the place. I see a winged creature. I see two people kissing. I see something with a tail. I see a crab. I see this, I see that. This is the kind of situation that people get into when they look at charts and try to interpret charts. In my experience, if you give someone a chart, you give it to 10 people, send them to a different room, have them come back with their interpretation, you'll get 8 to 9 different answers. That does not work. It never worked. It never will work unless you're a really good artist. So if you're not making money in this market, there's a problem. This market has been the easiest money making market I've ever seen. If you simply buy and hold, you'll make money. But that's not the strategy that we use. We use a very precise surgical strategy. And so how are you going to do that? You're going to make money by achieving success with specific fact-backed rules-based methods. Let me show you what I mean. If the average trader goes to the internet and says, teach me how to trade, they put in a search, they will get, and I kid you not, 80 million hits, most of which are advertising. What's the average person going to do? They're going to do the easiest thing. They're going to do the free thing. They're going to buy the free report, the free this, the free that. They probably won't get anything for it, and they'll blunder, and then they'll go back to the person who sold it to them and say, hey, it's not working. The person says, well, of course it's not working. You need some more stuff. You need to buy some stuff from me. So in my work, I use big data. What's big data? Prices, volume, open interest, statistics. The best traders in the world use big data nowadays. Why? Because it works. You can go to the computer and ask a question. We've got computers. Let's use them. Let's ask the question. Is this pattern that I learned from so-and-so or that I found in a book, is it working? Does it work? What's been its history? We're going to do some of that today. So traders interpret, but data speaks the truth. You can't get away from the data. It doesn't lie. I'm going to show you specifically what I mean. So you can read this later if you get the... David, are people going to get a copy of this presentation?
Yeah, the recording will be up on TimingResearch.com soon after you're done.
Okay, good. So in 1 hour, there's very little I can teach you. I can teach you a lot of things generally and say, you don't have all the pieces of the puzzle. I will be glad to sell you the rest of them. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to teach you one or two things extremely well so that you can go out and do them on your own and see if I'm right. So let's go forward. Choice number two. Okay, you can read this later. It's all about me. The bragging stuff, been all over the world, been on Wall Street Week, CNBC, FNN, you name it, I've been there. So I know what I'm doing, and I speak the truth to you today. I'm going to pronounce an obituary today. It's very dramatic. What died? Technical analysis died. What I mean is this. If you're sitting there looking at charts, drawing trend lines, looking at cups and handles, dojis, pennants, flags, you name it, you're in the dark ages. Most methods that work nowadays, especially by very successful traders, many of whom are my clients, about 57 of the biggest hedge funds in the world subscribe to my research, and they don't interpret anything. It's all numbers. There's no looks like. It's all about statistics. So using machine intelligence, machine learning, artificial intelligence, we find patterns. We take those patterns, ask the question, do they work? And if they work, we use them. If they don't work, we reject them. So I'm going to go through these slides very quickly because I want to get to the point. You can read this later. So here's this. Okay. This is the kind of stuff that most people are subjected to. I've highlighted in red every comment from a business TV reporter in one of the business shows that means nothing. So when you listen to the commentator and they tell you all this stuff, you have to ask yourself the question, do you really know what the underlying fundamentals are that this person referred to? What does the foreseeable future mean? What does strongly suggest mean? All of this stuff. So here's a mouthful. Prices could go higher over the short term within the context of an intermediate term downtrend resulting from uncertainty regarding the China, blah, blah, blah. And then after giving you all these conditional statements, they say, of course, geopolitical events could change this forecast dramatically at any time. We don't need that kind of stuff. We don't need this. Read this later. What we need is this. If you knew, and I'm going to go through this very quickly because you can look at it later, but this is super important. I will never, and I do mean never, under any circumstances, make any trade, no matter who recommended it, no matter where it came from, no matter what method it came from, unless I knew everything that's on this list and there's more of it. I want to know which market to trade. I want to know whether to buy or sell. I want to know the exact time or day to do the trade, the exact price, the odds of success, average profit, average loss, profit-loss ratio. Am I making more money when I'm right than I'm losing when I'm wrong? the complete track record, average profit, average loss, everything I want to know here is knowable. So just these first 12 things, ask yourself the question. Look in the mirror, be honest with yourself. Ask yourself the question, do I know everything on this list? Well, I respectfully submit to you that everything on this list is knowable. Why make a trade and risk your hard-earned money unless you know all of these things, especially if they're knowable? And what about these things right over here? Consecutive losses, consecutive profits, and the list goes on and on and on, and you say, well, this is really overwhelming. How can I do this? The answer is really simple. We have computers. We can do all of this. I'm going to show you one or two ways in which to do this. Again, I want to say this. It's not as easy as sitting in front of the machine. You already know that. What's important is know what you're doing. And the only way to know what you're doing is to have the numbers. We live in a day and age of computer technology. Use the damn thing. Let me show you what I mean. Here we go. If your charts look like this, you have a problem. It means nothing. Get rid of this stuff and let's ask a question. I teach and practice fact-backed rules-based trading because it works. You can look at this later, but check this out. I'm going to skip through all of this stuff. Actually, I'm going to go through this rather quickly. The most important piece of the puzzle is this. Are you an artist or are you a trader? If you're an artist and it's working for you, maybe you're psychic, wonderful, keep doing it. I use a trading model. I never analyze anything. I'm going to give you the trading model right over here. If there's any one thing that I can do for you, if you come away from this session with one thing that I believe will change your life, and encourage you to write me and say, Jake, you changed my life for the better. This is it. Every trade must have three elements to it. Number one, a setup. A setup is a pattern. There's thousands of patterns in the market. You name it, it's a pattern. People say, this double doji reversal, fabulous pattern. Wonderful. Ask the question. Put it on the computer. Program it. Ask the question, does it work? How often did it work? If you can't program it, it's not algorithmic. It's not rule-based. If it's not rule-based, don't use it unless you're an artist and a good artist at that. So the first thing we need is a pattern. Every pattern must trigger. So if I say to you, this pattern has been correct 68% of the time for the last 27 years, the question is, what about this time? Here's the pattern. Is it going to work? The pattern must have a trigger. I will show you how a pattern triggers. Once a pattern triggers, you act. Follow through. Average profit, average loss. Where's the target? Where's the stop? Where's the risk? And what's your profit maximizing strategy? These three elements are the most important. So, I also practice what I call the seven F words of trading. Don't laugh, but it's true. I'm going to go through this very quickly. And by the way, I cannot, in less than 1 hour, teach you everything I've learned in 52 years. But I can get close. The seven F words, and I keep this checklist all the time. Find trades that work. Find the right trades. Fact check those trades. Did you get the details right? Most people lose money on details, not on bad trades. Filter for risk. Even if a trade has been right 80% of the time or more in many years, no problem. Has that trade made you money or lost you money in terms of the risk that you have to take? If the risk is too much, no matter how good the trade is, it's not good enough for you because it's too risky. Now, follow through. Most people can't follow through on a trade. They don't know how to do it. Number five, finalize. Finalize the trade. When you do the trade, know the rules, make sure you know all the details, because if you get the details wrong, you're going to be in big trouble. Fix all your mistakes. You can't fix mistakes if you don't know that you made a mistake. The only way you know that you made a mistake is by keeping good records. There's so many ways in which we can keep good records these days. It's unbelievable. And most of them are free. You can get programs like that all over the internet. Next, formulate your trades, your next trade. That's easy to do. Go to your trading methodology and then apply the rules consistently. But forget about all that for now. There's a wealth of information here, but let's do this. Example, the golden cross and the death cross. You turn on the TV practically every day, you will see commentators talking about the 50 and the 200-day moving average. They say, when the 50-day moving average goes above the 200, it's called the golden cross. It's going to work. It's going to make you money. You have to buy. When it goes below, when the 50 goes below the 200, it's the death cross. You better be short. You better get out of your long or you're in trouble. There's so many opinions about this 50 and 200-day moving average, but let's look at the facts. The facts are very clear. Go to the computer and say, number one, these are the rules. If you applied the rules in S&P from 1988 to 2020, there have been 27 instances of this signal. Of those 27 instances, 48% of them have been accurate. Hey, you know what? That's pathetic. Absolutely pathetic. But you say, but look, it made money, net profit of $24,000. So what? Before it made that net profit, it took three consecutive losses and it required you to hold positions for 492 days. Who can hold a position for 492 days unless it's a losing position? Most people keep their losers till they grow hair on them. They get out of their winners very quickly. So for me, that's not viable. It's a losing proposition from the start. And on a track record, it looks like this. Absolutely pathetic, inconsistent, irregular. And so you say, yeah, but it's got a better history if you look at the Dow Jones, all the way back to the 1950s. So in this case, it's been 41% accurate. Yes, it's made 80, it's made 10,000 Dow Jones points. It's had six consecutive losing trades. So let's talk about that. Can the average person handle six consecutive losing trades? Most people cannot handle more than three consecutive losses. They get into a trade, they've never traded before, they lose money. They say, well, I didn't get into this as a perfect game, so it's understandable. I'm okay losing money once. They try it again. They lose money again. They say, well, I'm not happy, but hey, I didn't think it was going to be perfect. I'm going to try it again. They try it again. They lose money again. Say, wait a minute. Losing money three times in a row, that's not acceptable. I'm going to change my method and find something better. That's the end of the game for them. The fact of the matter is that some of the absolute best trading systems in the world will lose money six times in a row or more. So if you're not prepared for that, it's not going to work for you. And the track record of this methodology is similarly pathetic. Big ups and downs, a lot of drawdown, many years when it does nothing, unacceptable. So let's compare. Here's a simple pattern. Let me explain the pattern to you. 3 days, three bars, also works intraday. This would be day number one right over here on the left. Day number two. You will recognize day number two as being an outside day. Algorithmic definition, the high of day two is greater than the high of day one, and the low of day two is lower than the low of day one. Very simple. So simple, even a computer can find these. On day number three, if you close above the high of day number one, you buy it. If you close below the low of day number one, you go short. Even a computer can understand this. It's completely algorithmic. It's a total rule. If we take that pattern, set up, trigger, follow through, we put it on the computer and test it and ask the question, what does it look like? Well, here's what it looks like. Day number one, day number two. Day number two, you traded above the high of day number one. Day number two, you traded above the below the low day number one. There's your second day. Your third day, you closed below the low of day number one. You got out. First profitable opening. Let me show you again. Here's another one. Day number one, day number two, day number three, go short. Get out. First profitable opening. On the buy side, day number one, day number two, day number three, buy it at the end of the day. Get out. First profitable opening. Very simple. Now you might say, but Jake, you got these little moves, but you missed the big move. And you know what? We don't miss the big move because we have a methodology for that. So putting this on a track record, I want you to compare. We're not talking 60 or 80 trades. We're talking 645 trades, $172,000 net profit, 85.7% accuracy, 26 consecutive winning trades, 3 consecutive losing trades, 2.5 days in winning trades, 4.5 days in losing trades. That's all there is to it. So we know so much. Going back to what I said before, does this answer all the questions I posed in my list before? Buy or sell, where to get in, where to get out, maximum move against you, average profit, average loss, everything we wanted to know. And on the track record chart, it looks like this. So the computer found this method for us by searching a bunch of data. From this point forward, the computer did not know what the data was and went forward in real time with completely the same results, working extremely well, exactly as expected. What else do we know? By looking at the big data, by looking at the numbers, we know the monthly performance, percentage wins each month, average profit, average loss, and so forth. So we know the best months. We know the worst month, October. We know what to expect in February. Not such a great month, but considering what people know about markets, we know a heck of a lot more. So let's go forward. This is what the track record looks like. And you can see that in order to get in on the winning strategy, wait until it's taken a loss before you start trading. What do I mean by that? People look at these numbers and they'll say, this is really great. I want to start using this right away. My advice, wait. Wait for what? Wait until it has lost money 3 times in a row. That's right over here, because the worst it's ever been was 3 losses in a row right over here at the bottom of the screen on the right-hand side. So you say, well, yeah, but how often has that happened? Well, it's not happened very often, so you're going to wait. Wait until it's lost money once. Wait until it's lost money twice. But don't jump in right away, especially when it's had a winning streak. Wait for the drawdown. It's a very important rule of trading. So let's go forward again. How about this? Here's another example of a pattern. Excuse me. One of the best books ever written about the stock market is called The Behavior of Prices on Wall Street. The Behavior of Prices on Wall Street by Art Merrill, M-E-R-R-I-L-L. Merrill noticed that stock prices in the Dow Jones frequently go up the day before a major holiday. Example, Thanksgiving is always on a Thursday. The day before Thursday, of course, is Wednesday. Wednesday is the day that it goes higher compared to Tuesday. Strategy, buy on the close of trading Tuesday, get out on the close of trading Wednesday. Really simple rule. That pattern has proven correct 73% of the time or more since 1950. That's what I call a pattern, and those are the statistics, and it gives you all the rules. But still, people want to break the rules. I've been teaching this for many years, and invariably, on Tuesday morning, the day before the Wednesday higher close, people will call me and I say, should we get in now? I say, hey, the rule is get in on the close of trading. Yeah, but it's going up right now. I don't want to miss the boat. Then when it works, they call me on Wednesday morning and they say, hey, we open higher, we're making money, should we get out now? No, the rule is to get out at the end of the day. So people love to break the rules if they even know the rules. Now let's do this. Let's ask a more important question. Is there anything that happens even before this? Has there been a general pattern for prices to move higher or lower, a predictable pattern before Thanksgiving? And is it possible that it might continue until after Thanksgiving? So we go to the computer and we ask the question. The question is this. Computer, look at the entire month of November. Look at the entire month of December. Go through the big data, billions and billions of pieces of data, and tell me, has there been a pattern that takes advantage of this relationship? In other words, the pattern to go higher before Thanksgiving. The computer comes back and says, oh yes, here's the pattern. The pattern is this. If you bought S&P futures or the spider, end of day, market on close, November the 20th, and got out, market on close, December the 4th, risking 3% stop, you would have been right 81% of the time. Since the start of trading in S&P futures, your profit to loss ratio would have been 17 to 1, meaning the average winning trade in sum total was bigger than the average losing trade 17 times. Your average profit in points, your average loss in points, your percentage gain, your percentage loss, and you can look at the complete history of every trade. So I respectfully submit to you, this is what I mean when I say I'm a numbers guy, and this is what happens. So either you're going to believe the interpretation, or the, hey, it looks like it wants to find support here, or you're going to believe the numbers. If you believe the numbers, you will not always be right, but you'll be right enough times to make money. That's what I propose to you. So listen, ladies and gentlemen, if you're not making enough money, there's a reason for it. If you're losing money in a market where you should be making money, there's a reason for it. And the reason is you're doing something wrong. And what you're probably doing wrong is not knowing the numbers, not knowing what's on the list. So let's talk about this. The rule, buy on the close of trading November the 20th. If the market is closed on November the 20th, buy on the close of trading the next business day. Hey, this is called a seasonal trade, and it's complete numbers. Now, of course, people are going to say, well, it's not going to work this year because Trump's president and he's an idiot. Or they're going to say, well, we've got this China virus and it's not going to work. The bottom line is this. There's only one factor to consider. Number one, is the trade too risky for you? That's the number one factor. Are you willing to risk 3% stop close only on what the S&P futures are in the close of trading November 20th? If not, no problem. Mitigate your risk. Buy a call option. Put on a call option strategy. Do a binary option. Buy a stock. Buy a smaller position. Whatever you want to do. So I know the history of this trade. Look at it. All the way back to the start of trading, we're talking almost 40 years. Every entry date, exit date, price, and so forth, that's the history. And again, I don't know how many times I can say this, and I'm going to keep on saying it until I'm dead. If you don't have the numbers, you are not going to make money consistently. Know the numbers. For anything that you do, if you don't know the numbers, find them out. If you can't find them out because it can't be programmed, then it's not for you. Trust me. I know what I'm talking about. I've been around the block many times. So look, taking this stellar track record, and by the way, you might say, well, look, it's not getting in consistently. It's not getting in exactly. Well, look, look at the entry date on the left-hand side. Why are these dates different? Because of the rule. If the market is closed on the date of entry, get in on the close of trading the next business day. On the exit date, if the market is closed, get out on the close of trading the next business day. Then you might say, but wait a minute, how come it got out over here on November the 30th? Easy. It was stopped out. It's completely logical. So this is what the trade looked like in 2018. The year just ended. We'll look at it momentarily. So let's talk about psychology for a minute because I want to cover everything for you today. What's the psychology of this trade? The psychology is this. If you're like most people, you will look at this trade and you say, It's working too damn good. It can't possibly work this year. It's too good. It's due for a correction. Excuse me? Why do you say that? Well, look, it made a new all-time high last year. And you notice over here, it made a new all-time, then it corrected for a couple of years. I think that's going to happen again. My answer, hey, buddy, I don't care what you think. I don't care what I think. I don't care what anybody thinks. All I care about is the numbers. If the numbers are okay, I keep going. The other side of the coin is this. This is such a beautiful trade, Jake. Thank you for this wonderful gift. I'm going to bet the farm on this one. Wrong. Don't do that. Take it nice and slow and follow the rules. Trade within your parameters. So let's take a look at what happened. This is what happened in 2019. Before the trade happened, we knew the trade. Entry date, over here, reached its profit target. And then after the target was reached, it collapses. What was the target? Right over here, $2,450. Where did that come from? It came from right over here. Average profit, right over here, 19.83 S&P points. That's all there is to it. It's part of the strategy that we use. So let's ask another question. You're looking at the chart. Let's talk about psychology, because the weakest link in the chain is always psychology. That's what's going to screw you up worse than anything, even if you have these fabulous statistics that we have. Psychology. You know you're supposed to make the trade right over here on this date. You look at the chart and you say, oh my God, look how much higher it is than it was down here. I should have bought it down here. My answer, listen, smartass, if you should have bought it down there, why the hell didn't you do it? Or they look at it and they'll say, oh, it started a correction. I'm buying into a correction. It's going to go down. Over here, they'll say, oh, you know what? Jake's not such a bad guy. It's working. I think I'll get out before it turns around. So there's a million excuses. Or they might say, yeah, but look at this. You missed this move. And I say, I didn't miss that move. I've got six specific trading methods that I use. So don't worry about missing that move. It all depends on what you're going for. Can you go for all of them at once? You sure can. Let's look at something else. I go to my search location and I ask the question, are there any trades in S&P futures for the month of January that have been right 80% of the time, 15 days or less duration, January S&P in S&P. Computer comes back and says, you betcha. I'm sorry, not January, December. December and January. Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Computer says, you betcha there have been some trades. And here's the trade it found for me. And check this out. You remember what I told you about Art Merrill? The tendency for stocks to go higher before major holidays? Well, guess what? I do believe that December the 22nd is a few days before Christmas. So here's the Christmas trade, the pre-Christmas holiday trade. Buying March S&P, close the trading, December 22nd, getting out January 7th, risk 4%. Average profit, 23.21 points. But oh my, the accuracy is only 78%. No problem. Remember the formula, setup, trigger, follow through. In my work, any trade that has a accuracy of less than 80% needs a trigger. Therefore, because this trade needs a trigger, we need to use that trigger. The trigger is momentum, half the length of the trade. Example. If a trade is 10 days long from start to finish, and it's less than 80% accurate, we go to a momentum indicator, which the computer will give me, and say, what is half the length of the trade? 10 days. Divide that. And 10 days is the length of the trade. Divide that by 2, you get 5 days. You go to the 5-day momentum. Momentum is available on any trading software, also called rate of change. If the 5-day momentum is greater than 0, in other words, a positive number, and it's a buy trade, you go in at the market. If it's a sell trade and the momentum 5 days is less than 0, you go in at the market. Very simple. And by the way, if you don't understand this, well, let me back up and say this. If there's anything here that you don't understand, send me an email. I will send you a video explaining it to you so you don't have to worry about going through this quickly or missing the point. I would rather, as I said before, teach you one or two things really well than teach you a whole bunch of things in a bad way and have you need more information and make mistakes. So there's that other trade. And here is that trade. Entry, right over here, where the second green line is, right over here. Target, right over here, exit date over here. And again, how do we know that target? The computer gives us everything we need. Average profit 23.21. So what happens? Did we sacrifice this big move in favor of the small move? No problem. Method number two, moving average channel, which as I said before, I don't have time to teach you today, but that moving average channel methodology got us into the trade for the bigger move and is still in that trade as of the end of this chart. For this methodology, we use two moving averages, a 10 period moving average of the high, which is the red line on top. That's 10 period simple moving average of the highs, the green line, a 10 period simple moving average of the lows, 8 period simple moving average of the lows. And we use that in combination with an indicator called Williams accumulation distribution, which as I said, I'll be glad to teach you. I'll send you a video. So I'm going to give you a trade that's coming up. Today is January 31st. I'm going to give you this trade. Buying S&P March futures or the SPYDER, the SPY, or a call option at or in the money. End of day, February the 5th. If February the 5th is a day in which the market is closed, which it is not, it's a Thursday, okay. So you go Monday the 6th. No, I don't have my February calendar. Either way, unimportant. What's important is this. If the market is closed February the 5th, we get in on the close of trading the next business day. Very specific. Not during the day, not on the open, on the close of trading the next business day. We get out on the close of trading February the 15th, risking 3.5% stop. Or we get out at the average profit per trade, which is right over here, 21.76 S&P points. And that translates into dollars based on the futures contract. You can trade this with a micro S&P as well. You make 1/10 less, but you'll still be able to risk less. That's the trade. We know the complete history. We know the average profit, the average loss, everything we need to know. But there's one thing that I want to warn you about, and that's this. 78% win. Most people would be very happy with 78% win because most people can't even be right 50% of the time. But because it's 78% win, we need a trigger. So we're going to wait for a trigger. Okay, let me show you something else. Remember the list? Go through this list and ask yourself the question, is what Jake showed me today conforming to all the rules that he stated? I'm not going to go through this thing. You can do this yourself. What I've done here is a list of all those things that I usually look at in order to ask the question, what is going to lead me astray and what's going to work for me? For example, astrology might be good for entertainment, but in my view, it is not good for trading. How do I know that? I've tested it. Cycles work, seasonals work, divergence works, and so forth. So go through this when you have time. Let me show you something else. It is also true that stocks have patterns. You can find those patterns at seasonaltrader.com. You don't need to pay for seasonaltrader.com because it's a free website, trial basis. If you like what you see, you can buy it. Not a big deal. I don't make my money that way. It's a very small deal to me, but it's a very great research facility that I use all the time. Let me show you another trade. I want to emphasize something really important, and again, this goes to psychology. No matter how good the trades might be, no matter how accurate they might be, people will still find a way to screw them up. My job, not only to show you how to find good trades, but to show you how people will screw up. And the biggest way that people will mess up is by hesitation. Example, here's a trade that we had at Disney, buying. Close of trading, November 11th, getting up, close of trading, December the 5th, 15% risk and so forth. The question is, What are you going to do? We knew this before the trade happened. Here's the chart. This over here was a decision day, right over here. Looking at the chart, you can always make an excuse. The excuse over here being this. Well, look, it had a exhaustion gap. It opened on the high, closed down here. And this day it's falling through the downside. It's going to fill the gap. So I'm going to wait. What the hell are you going to wait for? You know the numbers. Don't wait. Do it. Do it when? Do it immediately at the end of the day. Or if not, do it immediately in the opening of the next day. And the opening of the next day, it's already making money. So people don't want to do the trade. Then Disney announces earnings. Its stock goes crazy and reaches, guess what? 5.77% profit. And the history told us before the fact, the average profit was 5.71% right over here with the red arrow. So the good news is the trade worked. The bad news is the trader often doesn't work. Another example. And by the way, you might say, well, why did the computer give me so many trades here? The answer is very simple. Computers are basically stupid. They can only tell you what you ask them to tell you. So when I go to the computer and say, show me all the trades for January or November or whatever that have been right 75% of the time or more with a profit to loss ratio of 4 or higher and so forth, the computer gives me all the possibilities. But because we're reasonably smart and the computer is reasonably stupid, we say to the computer, go through all of these possibilities that you gave me and put the best one in the first position. So this is the trade we take. Now, chances are, if this one works, they will all work, but that's not the point. The point is this, the reaction is immediate. Don't make excuses. So let me give you this. Here are a few of the trades that I've already selected for February. How do I know this? Because I went to the computer and asked about history. Let me talk to you a little bit about history. People say, this is data mining. There's really nothing there. It's an artifact of the data. The fact of the matter is, many of these histories go back 100 years. If you take a look at the Dow Jones and ask the question, has there been a pattern in the Dow Jones? Since the 1920s, there's been one pattern that's been right 85% of the time. And during all of these years, practically every fundamental that could happen to affect the market has happened. So therefore, you can't say it's a question of fundamentals. You can't say it's a question of chance. So here's some of my trades for the month of February. You will notice three of these trades have a probability in excess of 80%. I will not need a timing trigger. Excuse me. The only decision that I'll have to make is the risk acceptable to me? And remember, there are many ways to mitigate that risk. I'm going to talk to you about something else for just a minute, totally different. One of the most favorite indicators that people use is stochastic. Stochastic, stochastic, stochastic. I had a friend named George Lane many years ago who developed stochastic. And the way George would use stochastic is very simple. He would say, when the stochastic gets above 80% and goes down below it, go short. When it goes down below 20% and goes above it, go long. Buy it, go short. But over here, it gets kind of confusing and you get quote unquote whipsawed. So I looked at it and said, wait a minute, this is really not the best way to do this. I want to go to the overbought, oversold myth. Most people have no idea what overbought, oversold is because it doesn't exist. There is no overbought. Is the market overbought over here? Is it now more overbought? Is it overbought-er? Is it overbought-est? When you use an indicator like stochastic that has a theoretical upper limit of 100 and a theoretical lower limit of 0, stochastic can go to 90, stay above 90 while prices keep on moving higher and higher. So I developed another method that I call the stochastic pop, P-O-P. George Lane was very amazed when I showed it to him, and this goes back many years ago. He looked at it and he said, so when it doesn't work, do you call it the stochastic poop? I guess we do. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Here's a chart. Again, stochastic 14, 5, and 3. The blue line is the stochastic 14, this one here. When it goes above 90, above 80, you buy. When it comes back below 80, you get out. If it comes back above 80, you buy it again, you get out. You buy it, you get out. You buy it, you get out. From the point where this market, Palladium futures, went above 80% stochastic, the market moved $38,000 in one contract. Not typical, but amazing. So here's another one. We've been able to program the computer to find these for us, and we applied a filter. The filter we use is the moving average channel, which is referenced in my work. So when the moving average channel is in an uptrend, we take only the buy pops. When the moving average is in a downtrend, when the moving average channel is in a downtrend, we take only the sell pops. So on a screen, it looks like this. Hold on a moment, here we go. So again, the reason we've been able to do this on the computer is because it's algorithmic, it's rule-based. So here's another example and many, many different more. So David, I think we've got, what, 6 minutes left?
Yeah, almost. Yeah, just a couple minutes. Yeah.
Okay, so let me take some questions if there are any. Are we doing that today?
Yeah, if anyone has some questions. Not seeing any currently.
Okay, so let me go through this. If you need to reach me, by the way, I'm at this location right over here on the left-hand side. Here's my trade-futures.com email address and so forth. And my programmer, Chris, works with me. But let me show you something else. Everywhere I go in the world, people love day trading. They just love day trading. So let me show you something that I call the 30-minute breakout. This is the day session S&P, ES1, day session S&P, 15-minute chart. This is the first 15 minutes of the day. For the first 15 minutes of the day, we do nothing. Thereafter, anytime you get a 15-minute closing bar above the high of the first 15 minutes, you buy the next opening. Anytime you get a sell, a close below the low of the first 15 minutes, you go short. Your profit target is half the range of the first bar, which would be right over here. Your second profit target is the full range, and your third profit target is, again, the full range. So let me review. You do nothing. You buy at the close of the session or the opening of the next 15 minutes. I'm sorry, not the session, the 15 minutes. Target number one. Target number two. Target number three. And you're out by the end of the day. Another example, right over here. First 15 minutes of the day in pink. Buy trigger, buy target one, target two, out at the end of the day. Very simple strategy. Not perfect, but very simple because it contains all the elements that I told you about. You don't have to interpret anything. It's very, very simple. Let me show you another one. Hold on one moment. Do I have another one? Let me look. One moment, please. No, I do not have another one to show you, but take a look at what happened yesterday. Take a look at what happened the day before that, and you'll see. So, David, I am basically done here. Sorry I was a little bit late today. I'm glad to offer anybody who writes me a copy of my video, Six Best Timing Triggers, which explains everything in great detail. Anything else, David?
I think that's it. Great presentation. So thank you for being the first presenter today.
Sorry for being your first late presenter.
I'm sorry, that happens.
A little bit of stress, just like me.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I imagine it caused you a little bit of stress, just like me, when you're trying to get in.
Yeah, well, that's my job here, so.
Thanks for putting on a great show, everybody, and thanks for being here. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Jake.
Thanks, bye-bye.